Hi everyone, and welcome to this gardening special of FRIKAR Yoga. And today you only need your gardening tools. Might be something like this, or something like for cutting the grass. So we'll start up in 1 minute and just find your tools. And I will actually start this session today with a little horn play to wake up the birds. It's early morning here in Valdres, and the sun has not risen yet. So, it was not much of sound today, but it's like 4 degrees minus, and my fingers are a bit frozen. But let's start anyway. I'm Hallgrim, and I grew up as a Halling dancer here in Valdres. I'm working as a choreographer in FRIKAR Dance Company. And in FRIKAR, we are working towards connecting between human beings and nature. And that's also kind of why we are doing this kind of FRIKAR yoga sessions at YouTube and Facebook. We are inspiring a lot our arts from the old Norse heritage, which actually has a lot to offer to the contemporary human being when it comes to connecting to nature. So today we actually have this gardening special, and as you see, the trees are not green yet. There's still a little bit of snow in my garden, but there's a lot of old leaves to clean up and stuff to do. So nowadays I spend some time in the garden, and also I grew up in a sheep farm, and you can get a bit bored of doing all the practical stuff. So then it's good to have some break games or activities to do. So we will go through some of those games today in kind of a yoga training context. So let's just start then. Then we will start without the broomstick in the beginning, and we'll do some dragon breathing or andadreker. So then we are filling up the lungs and the body with air, and then we squeeze it out. You can tense all your muscles. Just have an image here, yes. You can tense all your muscles and squeeze out all the air. So we do it 6 times. I just show once first. And continue all the way. So let's do it together then. Are you ready? And breathe in. Breathe in and to empty the lungs and to squeeze out everything from the muscles. It's a really nice way to fire up the body, I feel. Now we go to the solkvedja, Norse for sun salutation. It's I put it together of traditional movements. Some I learned from the living traditions, or others are kind of coming from Bronze era petroglyphs. So let's go through it together. Some of you have been with me for some weeks and you know it already, but I will explain a bit carefully anyway. So then we can take an imaginary axe. Let's say it's Mjölnir, the axe of Thor. Spread your feet a bit try to grasp the ground, even though you probably have shoes on. And so it's three times this movement. We open up the hip, open up the chest, breathe in through the nose, and then we can breathe out through the mouth when chopping. Three times that, and then it's spiral movement, like chopping a tree, a trunk. Okay, so let's start. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in. And third time. And spiral to the right. Good. Three. Fjorir. Fim. And six. The sixth time, the right knee goes through this window. So we sit down, we put this elbow against the knee, so we get this kind of knot of gleitner, the only rope which could bind the wolf of Fenris. Then we turn with the sun. With the sun is kind of to the right when you're standing. Breathe in, hip forward, open up your chest, and chop. And then we breathe up, have your toes down on your back right foot, and then we are going to drink from the well of Mimir, water of wisdom. You might use your hands in the ground, or you could try balancing. And drink the water. We go up, still weight on left leg. Spread your eagle wings. And then we turn with the sun. Try to get the foot down in the floor, so we get this nice little stretch on the inside of the thigh. And we turn all the way until my north. So if you want, you can try a little balance here with kruking. Ancient Bronze Era movement, which is coming from this, which we are not doing now. Now the right leg is forward. You push down with the elbow, and with the left arm, you can have this side stretch. It's a little bit of a balance challenge for some of you, but it's a good training. And then try to grab your toes and pull back. Then you will have this nice stretch in the leg and the hamstring. Okay. So then I continue to turn with the sun until my right leg is wrapped around my left. Then it's comfortable to lean back, roll back, elbows down in the floor, in the ground, and push up to this snake getting up from the coil. So this is good to include the neck in the warm-up. And then we can go down with the knees alongside our ears, and then I turn to my right side, my right elbow being in the ground all the time, like going to this cat pose. So then we take the dragon breath here, and we push up into the mountain. Oh, that's good. And heels up, and do this ripple with your back. And dragon breathe. Two times more. Breathe in through the heel and ripple. And push up again. Last time. Ripple. And push up and stay in the mountain pose.
And right leg goes up.
And we place it in between the hands, which is a nice exercise in itself. How are you feeling? It's a bit cold ground here today in Valdres. And breathe in. Hip forward, open your chest and chop. And breathe in. And then we go for drinking the water of Mimir. Go up again, spread your eagle wings. Keep your weight on your right leg. And turn slowly with the sun this time. Not against the sun, yeah. To your left. Mm-hmm. So, here we are sitting in the kruke position. You might try this balance. Okay, good. Now the left leg is forward instead of the right. Push it down with the left elbow. Do the stretch here with the right arm. And grab your foot and pull back into this flex stretching of hamstrings and leg. Do you feel it? Okay. So then we walk like a lynx here to with the sun, left leg goes through and take Mjölnir, the axe, and push against the knee. And we look with the sun. And then we turn against the sun to get up into the spiral movements and we chop left and right. And frir, fjurir, fim, sex, and then three frontal. Sjau, åtta, niu. Oh, so that was the solkvedja today. I think I should get on some gardening gloves. But the sun is actually starting to rise now. So it's so beautiful to be outdoor early in the morning. Do you hear the birds? So, as a part of the solkvedja, I'd like to sing a solkvedja song from Hovamål to you. It's in old folk melody. So, eller bester med yta sonum och solar syn heilindis sitt. F mother half an öran vid lust att lifa. So this ancient text might be from 600-800s, written down in the 1200s. It's this verse talks about fire is best for the sons of the earth. And with the sight of sun, the health is good. As long as a man can get a son, he will have lust for life. So I think it's a good morning text. There's also one relevant Hovamål text today, which I will read for you. And it's about gardening, at least your work at the field. So, Akri Arsonum, Trui Engi Madr, Ne Til Simma Syni, Veder Redder Akri, En Vit Syni, Het Es Veira Vart. So it, I will have the translation up here. Don't, yeah, it's about don't trust the early seeds that you spread out and even don't trust your son too early, because the seeds are depending on the weather, and your son is depending on wisdom, and you don't have control of either. So that was the gardening kind of words of the day today. So let's go into the real training practice. Then we will need a broomstick or some gardening tool. The length is not important, but it should not be less than a bit more than 1 meter. So I'll have this, and then we will start with kind of Niflheim practice, which is about the home of the ice in the Norse creation. So this movement is all about control. So I put my foot down at the floor and sink down my hip, and I place this on my other foot, my right foot now. I use this kind of Draupner ring around the broomstick to make sure that it's balancing and I don't need the ring anymore, maybe. Then I can start balancing. I try to sink down in the hip. Oh, that's good. It's really difficult, at least in the beginning, so it might be nice to keep the ring of your fingers around the staff. And after a while, maybe you feel it's burning in your leg, which is kind of part of the benefit that we want from this. This exercise. So, do you feel it's burning in your leg? That's good. We'll do it on the other side. I will just have a quick check if the stream is going okay. Yeah, that's good. So nice to see you here. Mm-hmm. And now you might see that the sun is actually hitting me. I'm so happy. So that was my left standing leg. Now I'm standing on my right leg. So I'm turning to my east, where the sun is coming from. And I let go of the ring, but you might keep the ring on. Try to sink down, avoid unbalanced in your upper body, and try to do the adjustments down. I will do it once more. Normally we have one good side and one bad side, and my bad side is actually on the right standing leg. This is a really nice coordination game that I grew up with at the farm, which is good to ground and have kind of equal training on both sides, which were really important in the Konungsskuggsjå, the book of wisdom from the 1260s. Advices for warriors, for instance. So, I don't believe it was a lot of tips for gardening there, actually. So, that was this first task. Then we will do a lynx trap. Lynx trap is really good for your thighs, to waken them up and to practice them. Then you have the kind of the same good grip here. And we go down, maybe 90 degrees, and you can push with your broomstick up again. And you might also try it on toe, which is much more difficult. And 90 degrees, for instance, and push up. Yes. Doesn't look very spectacular, but it's a really good training. And breathe in up to your toe and push out. Breathe in the break and push. Breathe out, going up. Are you ready for going all the way down? You don't need to, but try to practice on your level. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Yes. And on the other side. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Yes. So let's do it twice on both legs after each other. And sinking down. Woo. Once more. Oh, it's so good to find the balance in the starting of the day. Last time. And up. Yeah. That's good. How are you doing? Please leave a comment if you want other stuff in the practices. I will have a little look at my plan. Actually, something that we have not done much in the earlier sessions is to twirl, which is a really nice way of kind of loosen up your shoulder and your back. And the back is maybe kind of one of the most important problems that we have in our society today. So have a good overgrip, not undergrip, but overgrip of the staff. And then this is kind of normal kayak paddling, you agree? But now we are going to paddle on the opposite side. So my right side here, I take it up and down on the wrong side. Yes, and then I take my left side on the wrong side. Yes. Okay. So I'm kind of leading with my little finger on the other side. On the other side. Yes. It might be some coordination. So just start very slowly and then you can speed up. Mm-hmm. And you might also notice that I'm bouncing down when I'm going for the stretch on the opposite side. Yes. And the stronger fist you have, the better kind of training you get, because you need more flexibility in the shoulder and the torso if you have not a loose grip. And so, speed up if you want. Oh, that's good. I hope you manage and try to work with your flexibility. Where it stops, try to breathe out when it's kind of stopping a bit. So, and actually Hovamor also tells about don't leave your weapons at the field, because you never know where and when the enemy will arrive. So, if you manage to have the capacity of using these sticks as a weapon, it's a good practice and quite fun practice as well. So, that was the twirling for today. And we're going, and now we have gone through the kind of the control-based movements. We're going from the Nivelheim to Muspelheim now. And Muspelheim is about the fire. And let's fire off the body with some kind of sword throwing. And the sword throwing is kind of a practice of this movement. And then we take the broomstick. We might maybe, if you manage, hold on top, but you might also just grip around. And I go down and I push up. if it's slippery, it's a bit difficult. Even better training for the grip, but let's try. 10 times each second side. 1, 2, that's good. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, come on, that's good. 8, 9, 10. So that's really good. The longer distance you have from the feet and the broomstick, kind of the harder training it is. That was kind of the throwing of the spear. And we can do some explosivity work if you want. And it's pretty nice to do it at the grass actually. So then you have a really kind of loose grip of your staff to avoid hitting your nose at the ground. So if you lose the broomstick, nothing happens. So this is a game that I grew up with. It was really popular, and we look forward. If you look down, the butt goes out and you lose energy. So yes, it might be easier without shoes because the shoes build some centimeters. Let's try it once more. Quite fun exercise to do when working. And once more. Yes, and it is possible to do back and forth. Then I'll actually take a light broomstick today because I don't feel so much explosivity today. Let's try it. Are you ready? Back and forth. Oh, I'm happy I managed today. One kind of exercise that you can do is a heldehopp, which we normally don't use the broomstick for. We just hold the toe and then jump through. But you might use the broomstick as a support for this movement, so which makes it easier to learn as well. You might try on the other side. Might be really difficult for some, even for me. And on the other side. Let's go. And on my bad side again. Okay. So that was some explosivity work. So, let's go for some Jormungandr exercises, which is more about this serpent quality. The serpent of the world biting its tail around the world is a very important character from Norse mythology, and also about, I feel, the connection to the earth, because maybe Christian writers have kind of interpreted it, this serpent as an evil monster, but it was also believed that as long as you didn't tease the nature or the serpent down at the bottom of the sea, it will lie calmly and there would not be big storms on the surface of the ocean. So be kind to nature and it will be kind to you, kind of moral. So, but before we get there, let's have some music. Today I don't have music on the Spotify, so I'll play a springar, a traditional tune from here, from Valdres. It's called Vårflaumen, the spring flood. I feel it's maybe good to call for the spring to arrive here in Valdres now. So that was a song in three divided rhythm, which we use for springer dancing in couples here in Valdres. So let's go for the Jörmungandr movements, and then we have avoiding the spear, Smette Mjuke. Then I stand towards my son here, and I have undergrip at the staff. I put it behind me, my maybe kind of 4 feet, 3-4 feet behind, and I start to lead with the top of my head, the crown, and I try to get forward with my hip and knees, and then I go under both arms, and I kind of twist my legs. So let's try it together. You might start quite high, which is good in the morning, and breathe in on your toes. Breathe out, leaning back and forward. Under here, and we start to twist the legs. Yes, and let's try to the other side. Breathe in and breathe out. Yes, so you can go further and further down. Let's try all the way down for those which want. Now it's also downhill in the garden here, so it's a special challenge for me today. And breathe in. Oh yeah, I should go a bit lower actually. Let's try together, last side. Breathe in and breathe out. So that was avoiding the spear. And let's tread the needle, which is kind of one of the most popular games here in Valdres. It even was a popular Corona challenge around the world. You have the back grip on the broomstick, and you take it over your head. You might even have more narrow, and if you have a strong fist here, it might be a good practice for your shoulders. So breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in here, slide towards the end. My right is on my end, and then I take my right leg on the outside and I breathe out, threading the needle. Breathe in, sliding up, and we go into this stretch. We hold the stretch for a little while, and we slide around the butt, and we step out. Woo! I think I'll have some warm drink. It's still minus degrees here. A little tea with honey. I hope you have some drink for yourself as well. So then, I'll try to do it on my bad side, or the opposite side, which is the left side here. And let's do it together. Are you ready with back grip on the staff? breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in, step on your right leg and breathe out. Breathe into the big stretch and breathe as you want. And slide around the butt and step out. Yes, that's good. So the last task for today, I think we might try to do the ratatosker, which is a squirrel in the Norse mythology, climbing up the trees and down the tree, kind of being the messenger between the big eagle and the snake in the ground. And it's about standing on your hands, and then you can lean the broomstick towards your butt. And we now try to reach the ground without losing the broomstick, which might be a challenge sometimes. So use your toes to kind of break, reduce the speed, and keep control. And this is quite difficult with shoes, but we try to push down here so you manage to climb. It's easier to use your toes around the stick, the gap between the big toe and the next toe. Push through your shoulders. And we can slide down like a fireman. So that was the ratatosker. Let's try it once more. So normally I have my bigger toe and the next toe gripping around like a monkey. But with shoes, it's difficult. Then I just push with resistance. It's far too cold here today to go without shoes. So let's try it once more. Breathe in and breathe out. And then we start to put weight on it, and we climb up, push through your shoulders, oh yeah. So that was everything for today, and please leave a comment on how the level is working for you, the kind of tasks and so on. It's meant for being a kind of intermediate and advanced level. It's maybe easier if you have practiced yoga or similar training before. But it's good to get some feedback. And thank you so much for all the donations on Vips and PayPal, which makes it possible to give these classes for free. And remember to subscribe and follow FRIKAR if you like what we are doing. We are appreciating it so much, especially in this time where we are not able to go around to do the shows because of Corona. So see you next Friday. Have a good weekend.